been to the produce section in your grocery store? You know, the place that has the vegetables and the fruits? And then you all of a sudden hear some thunder, and then it starts pouring down rain on all the vegetables? Why do you think that happens? Who'd want to buy this piece of celery? This celery's experiencing wilting. And if you think about your cell parts, this is occurring because the central vacuole has lost water. Therefore, the plant itself has lost Turgor pressure. If you think about a way to get Turgor pressure back into this plant, you'd have to fill up that central vacuole with water. So you could possibly place this celery into some water, and as it uptakes the water, it would fill that central vacuole up, and then it would become rigid again. So here we have two carrots, and what we've done is place these two carrots in two different samples of water. One sample of water also contains salt, and it's a saturated solution. So that means every little space in between the molecules of water is taken up by salt. Over here, we have distilled water, which is nothing but water. So there's nothing additional in it. So when you get water from the tap, well, there's all sorts of other kinds of things in that water. But in this water, in distilled water, it's nothing but H2O. So we have these two samples, and these carrots have been sitting for 24 hours. So let's take a close-up look at our carrots. This is our carrot that's in distilled water. And you'll notice that when I try to bend this carrot, it does not bend much at all. So you're looking at a carrot that has a full central vacuole. And you're looking at a carrot that has something called Turgor pressure. So that vacuole is full and it's pushing out on the cell membrane in the cell wall. Now you might think that this string is here just to be able to pick up our carrot and pull it out, but in fact it's not. The string is there to show the change in diameter. This string was tied tightly to this carrot before it was put in the distilled water, and you'll notice you can't move it. You can't make it move up and down the carrot. So the diameter has actually increased slightly around that string. Now, keep this visual in mind of how hard this is to bend, and then look at what happens when we put the carrot in salt water. So our salt water solution is a saturated solution. That means every molecule in between the water molecules is filled up with salt. And so look at what happens with this carrot. Look how easy it is to bend. So imagine the central vacuole in this one. The central vacuole in this one has lost water. The water has gone out through the process of osmosis into the surrounding water in the beaker. Now, notice also that the string, I can just roll it up and roll it down the carrot. I can almost get it to the end of the carrot. And that's because the diameter has decreased. The diameter decreased because the central vacuole let all the water out, or most of the water out, and the carrot has lost Turgor pressure. So let's think about what a cell looks like when it has Turgor pressure and when it's lost Turgor pressure. So we're gonna draw a cell, a representative cell of our carrots or our celery. And we've got our cell wall right here, which serves as protection and support for the cell. Then we're gonna draw our nucleus, and in a plant cell, your nucleus is generally shoved off to the side simply because you have this large central vacuole that in some cases can take up like 90% of the volume of the cell. So when you have a vacuole that's completely full of water, then you're gonna notice that it's gonna be able to actually force out the cell membrane and the cell wall. So in all directions, it's going to be able to force out the cell membrane and the cell wall. And this is a plant that would have Turgor pressure. Now, suppose you just don't water this poor plant, or you stick it in salt water like we did with our carrots. What do you think might happen to that vacuole? So a cell that has no Turgor pressure or has a loss of Turgor pressure, that vacuole is going to be significantly smaller. And at this point, you can see it is unable to exert the force out on to the cell wall and the cell membrane to be able to maintain that Turgor pressure, so to be able to maintain rigidity. Now, why does this happen? Well, if you think about what's outside the cell, like for instance, if the salt water is outside the cell, then what the cell is going to attempt to do is create a state of equilibrium. So it's going to send that water through the process of osmosis. It's going to send that water out into the surrounding environment, into the intercellular environment, to be able to create a state of equilibrium. And that's when you'll see that the plant has lost Turgor pressure.